Hello, I'm Mr. R. Niger, a retired lecturer in hematology, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Here I'm going to render exposition of a Gnostic Gospel of Philip, translated by Wesley W. Eisenberg, part 51. And this is important because the Jewish people, they dominated the churches, and after Saint Stephen and Saint James the Just, the next bishop, they gave in to the pressure by the Jews, and they bring in their Jewish leaven, which is the written Torah. This written Torah, the Samaritans and the Gentiles were not reading, not paying much attention to, but their moral laws, they were written over their hearts. So they were spiritual. They were not applying dead letters. Remember Jesus said, letter killeth, spirit giveth life. Remember the Samaritan man who picked up a wounded person? The two men of letters, they passed by. And they did not bother, they had no mercy in their heart. Whereas a man of spirit, Samaritan man, came, he did not ask him, what is your tribe or which country you come from? He just picked him up and looked after him. And that is called philanthropy. And philanthropy comes from God. Whereas these people who are money-minded, Jewish people, they were not philanthropic. So after these two bishops, the other bishop became corrupt. They bring in the demon of the Jewish leaven. The apostle used to visit their churches and they used to rebuke them for their malpractices. And when they came into power under Nero, then they asked the Emperor Nero to kill those people who do not comply with their wishes, that they too should read the written Torah. So they start killing people by putting them before the animals. They were men of spirit, but they wanted men of letters, the dead men. So that's how they killed the Christianity. And after killing the Christianity, then they went down to corrupt the gospel. And then they start corrupting it, because this is the dark ages, the age of the psychic. Psychic are people who want to please everyone. So the people who speak the gospel truth do not please everyone. They please our Father God. Like politicians, they are psychic. This is a good example. For the sake of their votes, they will even please the wrong man against the right. So they don't care. They want votes only, by hook or by crook. So these bishops, which were messianic, they were psychic. By hook or by crook, they wanted a following. And their followers are normally once-born people who cannot think. So to catch them, so they made the story so pathetic that when Christ Jesus was on the cross, he was crying, my God, oh Lord. Why? He is not Lord, our Father. He is Spirit. Spirit sets you free, not bind us. Have you forsaken me? This is all nonsense. Because Christ Jesus was going back to his parents' home, which is the best place to go for. And people, you know, when they are preaching gospel, they don't care for their death. They carry their cross. They are in the previous video I said, they are in the chamber, which is very hot, very hot. And because once you are in the sealed to serve God, then people despise you, people hate you, because you speak the gospel truth, not to please them, but to please God. So when these messianic people, they became psychic and pushed the apostles out, and then they start killing them, and then they altered the scriptures, and all these alterations are to strike at the soft heart of the simple-minded people. It was on the cross that he said these words, for he had departed from that place. Here you are, he departed from that place, means that is his home, Father's home, he was going back. So how can he say, forsaken me? He should be happy going back over there. Who has been begotten through him? So Christ Jesus was begotten from our Father, God. Who from God? Him, says there's something missing, you know. The missing from the dead. To be, but now, something missing, perfect flesh. Now Jesus, you know, he died, and when before that, the flesh he was having was not perfect. But when he rose up in the resurrected state, then it was perfect and true flesh. Remember, Jesus walked and showed himself to his workers after his death, and that flesh was real, true flesh. The false flesh, he threw it away. It is true flesh. It's not true, but only possesses an image of the true. That means there's something missing, you know, again. You know, Jesus possessed the very image of our Father. So that's why Jesus said, those who have perceived me have perceived my Father. So Father, God is spirit. And you cannot see with your two naked eyes. So that's why these days, you know, you hear people, where is God? Show me the God. No, that stupid question, you know. How can you show God when God is spirit? You can only prove it through logical reasoning, as I proved the virgin birth of Christ Jesus. And that is a good way, you know, a good exercise to prove that logical reasoning works. So the logical reasoning reveals you the gospel truth, and that is why gospel truth is called logos. So person who is capable of logical thinking is called twice born. The person who is incapable of logical reasoning is called once born. In the next video, it's a very beautiful video coming up. And in that one, the once born people are called animals. And those people who follow the others, they are called slaves or prostitutes. And only the free men, which are the solitary, only they enter into the royal kingdom of God. I will explain that one in detail. So here you should be careful that this dark age is the age of the psychic. There are four ages. There's a perfect age in the beginning when everybody was in the company of God. That is Adam and Eve living in the company of God. Everyone was saint. Saints are different from angels. So then the degradation came and death came. And when death came, that age is called angelic age. The people were taught the moral laws. And when people were perfect in moral laws, they were called angels, as people of Judah tribe were. And in India, we have people of Khatri tribe. So when more degradation come, then people have become simpleton, once born. So they are incapable of thinking, so they follow the rabbis like blind people. So the rabbis lead them. This is the age of the Christ. Christ, when we only